Hello students, a very warm welcome to Meso Study Biology session. Now in today's class I'll be talking about a certain prenatal diagnostic test. So as you can see behind me, it is written as amniocentesis. Yes, amniocentesis is one of the procedure of a prenatal diagnostic. Now what do you mean by prenatal diagnostic? That means before the birth of a baby, if the baby is suffering from any kind of genetic abnormalities or any kind of inherited disorder, that can be easily detected so that parents can be prepared before the birth of a baby. So for that we have two different procedures. One is amniocentesis and second is a chorionic villi sampling. So these are the two methods which actually creates confusion among students. So after this session, the confusion between this chorionic villi sampling and amniocentesis will be clear to you. Now, first procedure which I am dealing right now, that is amniocentesis. Now, amniocentesis is the procedure in which amniotic fluid is taken out. That's the reason this particular test is also termed as amniotic fluid test. It is termed as an amniotic fluid test. So amniotic fluid is actually a fluid in which the baby is present. So this is a baby and this is baby is connected to mother via this placenta. So what we used to do, we take a syringe and this syringe is allowed to pass through the abdomen of mother along with these ultrasound transducer so that exact location of the baby can be simultaneously detected. And one thing we should keep in mind while taking out this fluid, amniotic fluid, that it should not affect the placenta. If it will affect the placenta, chances that miscarriage can happen, right? So this syringe is taken, a long needle syringe is taken, that is inserted into a stomach area which crosses the uterus, and which after that this particular fluid is being taken out, and that fluid is termed as an amniotic fluid. Now listen very carefully. Now this amniotic fluid which is present around the baby, they will be having some cells of the baby. So that is the reason amniotic fluid is taken. So amniotic fluid, it has cells of baby, right? Now these cells, once this amniotic fluid is taken out, these cells are analyzed for what? For chromosomal abnormality. For chromosomal abnormality. So if there is any kind of chromosomal abnormality, genetic disorder, inherited disorders, if they are present, that can be easily detected. Now one thing is, when can a pregnant mother can go for this amniocentesis procedure? For this you should keep in mind, this can be done at the 15th week of pregnancy. 15th week of pregnancy, right? Is it clear to you? So this is amniotic fluid test. Now this is first method. Let's talk about the second method. Second method is chorionic villi sampling. That is chorionic villi sampling. Chorionic villi sampling is a method in which the chorionic villi, they are taken out. Chorionic villi, where it is present? Of placenta, taken out via needle. Now listen to this. This is a baby and this baby is attached to mother via this placenta, and this placenta will be having chorionic villi present in them. Now with the help of, see, there are two methods for the chorionic villi sampling. So, methods. One is a transvaginal and second is a transabdominal. It's all up to doctor. Doctor actually decide whether the person, whether the lady will be going for transvaginal chorionic villi sampling or she will be going for the transabdominal chorionic villi sampling. Now, why? What is the reason behind it? Transvaginal, that means we will be using one catheter and that will be passing through the vagina. This is this actually depends upon the position of the placenta. And second is a transabdominal, where the needle is taken just like that of amniocentesis and that is inserted into the abdomen, which passes through the uterus. And once it is reaches up to this chorionic villi region of the placenta, the cells of these, they are taken out. Yes, a local anesthesia is applied over to the stomach region and everything is under the ultrasound transducer. Right? So, these are the two different methods. Now, listen very carefully. This particular method is done between 11th to 13th week of pregnancy. Whereas amniocentesis, this is done once the amniotic fluid is completely formed, that is around the 15th week of pregnancy. Now, this is another method which is you can say a quite safer than amniocentesis, and this particular method can detect any kind of chromosomal abnormality like before it. So, it is very easy method so that parents, they can go for any kind of decision, like a person, baby is suffering from some cystic fibrosis or any kind of other genetic disorders, they can prepare themselves and like this. One of the disadvantage of these two methods is the sex detection of the baby. Yes, this is actually a problem in our society that a woman is considered as a curse and women is actually considered that she will be dependent upon the parents, but actually it is not the case. They are equal to the man, that we all know. And this is a major problem where when they get to know about the sex of a baby, that if she is a female, they abort it. So that prenatal diagnostic of sex, that is not allowed in our country. So these are the two different methods, that is chorionic villi sampling and amniocentesis. So hope the difference between both of these, the amniocentesis done at the 15th week of pregnancy, around 14 to 15 week of pregnancy, this is done at that time. Now chorionic villi sampling, this is done at the 11th to 13th week of pregnancy. In the amniocentesis, we take out the amniotic fluid and the transabdominal, needle is inserted into the patient's body. Now, in the second case, it can be a transvaginal, it can be a transabdominal, where the chorionic villi, which will be having the cells of a baby, they will be taken out, they will be sent to the laboratory, and the disease such as a Down syndrome and other abnormalities, they can be easily detected. So, hope both of these procedures, they are clear to you, very important these are. So, let's wind up the session here. We'll be meeting in the next one. We'll be discussing some other topic. Take care. Thank you so much, students, for watching this.